Hi students, I am Pawan, your science master. Today I would like to speak to 7th standard students. Students, in the previous class we have talked about acids and bases, and especially the sub-concept we discussed was indicators. I think you have understood the live experiment that we have done in the last video. What type of indicators we used in the last video? Whether we used natural indicators or artificial indicators? That's right. We used natural indicators. What were those natural indicators we used in the previous class? That's right, turmeric and hibiscus. Today's learning objectives are: what is acidic or basic nature, names of some materials to be tested, litmus paper, what is lime and lemon water and preparation of them, lab activity with magnesium ribbon. First of all, let us know what is acidic or basic nature. In general terms, what is acidic nature? Let us understand. The materials that are sour in taste and burn in sensation. For example, lemon, orange, apple, etc. Now let us understand the basic nature of the materials. The materials which are bitter in taste, soapy to touch, are basic in nature. The examples for basic nature materials are soap, glass cleaner, etc. Now let us understand what is acidic or basic nature in scientific terms. Acid in scientific terms is a substance with particular chemical properties, including turning blue litmus to red and corrosive in nature. Here you have to understand what is litmus paper. Litmus paper is an artificial indicator which can indicate the nature of other materials. Okay students, acids are also corrosive in nature. What is corrosive in nature? Corrosive nature means it's a damaging nature. Acids may damage some of the materials like metals. If you store acids in metal containers, that may damage the metal by making holes. So, storing acids in metal containers is good or bad? That's right. It's not at all good, because acids may damage the metal containers. So, we should not store acids in metal containers. Now, let us understand what is base in scientific terms. Here, base is also a substance with particular chemical properties, including turning red litmus to blue and bitter in taste. Once again, let me teach you what is litmus paper. Here, litmus paper is an artificial indicator. What? It's an artificial indicator made up of paper. It is available in two types. One is blue and another one is red. Did you ever see litmus paper, students? The litmus papers are available in the market. You can ask in stationery shops. You can get litmus papers from any stationery shop. and you can do the experiments on your own. Students, the materials names will be displayed on the screen. You can see and collect as many as possible materials that are displayed on the screen and test them with the litmus paper. Students, now I read the names of the materials or substances. You please repeat after me. Orange, tomatoes, baking soda, mineral water, shampoo, washing soda, spirit, saliva, cucumber, ridge gourd, kheera, buttermilk, milk, cold drink, lemon juice, grape juice, bathing soap, detergent soap, lime water, and sugar water. Students, I have taught you about the nature of acids and bases, right? And the action of acids and bases with litmus paper also I taught you. And the red litmus paper is turned into blue with base. And blue litmus paper is turned into red with acid. So if there is no change, then that is a neutral substance. So you have to test the materials with the litmus paper and write your observations in the table given on the screen. And you have to classify all of these materials based on their nature. Nature means whether they are acidic in nature or basic in nature or neutral in nature. Now let us talk about what is lime water, how to prepare it. Students, what do we call lime in our local language? That's right, sunnam. The lime we have to collect, usually we apply to betel leaves, right? Betel leaves in our local language, tamalapakulu. You might have seen some of the people chewing betel leaves using lime in that. That lime you have to collect. After you add that lime to water, you have to stir it well and let it stand overnight and filter the solution the following day. After you filter, you get filtrate, right? That filtrate is nothing but lime water that looks transparent after you filter. Most of the students are confused by lime water and lemon water, but they are not same. Lime water is made by lime. Lemon water is made by lemon juice. Lemon water can be prepared taking a lemon and cut it and squeeze it. You have to collect the lemon juice in half glass of water and then this will be the lemon water. Students, do you know what is a magnesium ribbon? It's a chemical substance. And this is available in a solid form. And you know how to prepare magnesium hydroxide? What is magnesium hydroxide? This is also a material, chemical material, which is in liquid form. And this can be prepared by using a magnesium ribbon. To do this activity, you have to take small piece of magnesium ribbon with the help of tongs and you have to burn the magnesium ribbon. After you burn it, you get ash. You have to collect that ash and dissolve that ash in water.
After dissolve that, you have to touch the water with your fingers. How do you feel? Do you feel like a soapy touch? Yes, you will definitely feel a soapy touch. Now you take a strip of red litmus paper and hold one end of the litmus paper in your hand and dip another end of the litmus paper in the sodium hydroxide solution. Will you observe any change of color of red litmus paper? Yes, you will definitely observe the change of color of red litmus paper into blue. Now, how can you conclude the nature of sodium hydroxide solution? Whether it is base or acid? That's right, it's a basic substance. So, magnesium hydroxide is basic in nature. Now, I would like to give you the summary of this lecture. The summary of this lecture is, what is acidic or basic nature? Names of some materials to be tested by litmus paper. What is litmus paper? What is lime water and lemon water and preparation of them? And finally, lab activity with magnesium ribbon. The assignment based on today's lecture is, what happens if we store acids in metal containers? Students, in the next class, we'll be discussing about names of some acids and bases. Be prepared for the next class. Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all.